So what do you think the role of the brain could be in this spiritual model of the universe? For instance, Roger Penrose and Hameroff's model with the microtubules, quantum mathematics of the microtubules, do you not think that that might still be a good approach to the reconciliation of materialism and spirituality and the brain and the soul and the interface?
You see, this fixation on matter is becoming very tiresome. This is what I'm saying. Because I'm just telling you, quantum is telling us the material world that you are so sure about is an appearance. Maybe it's just an appearance. Why do you want to try and explain everything in terms of material things? So, for example, this big thing, I mean, just kind of lighten up. It was Mr. Lakhani, consciousness is a brain phenomenon, I live with it, and all this nonsense and all this airy fairy stuff. If he hit you with a hammer, your consciousness will go. He told you it's in your brain. I said, no, it is not. It's like breaking a switch. Electricity will stop, but it doesn't mean it stopped the flow. It's just that flow has stopped. You're not touched consciousness. So trying to do something in a field where it doesn't exist, like consciousness, the reason why consciousness will never be captured in any material sense is because it is precisely that. It is not, if you like, part of the apparent world. It is very much the underpinning to reality, so it cannot be captured at the cell, put it in jars and sell it in Sainsbury's. It always stay like that. It is not the weakness. People think when you talk about this stuff like consciousness, it is we can't kind of grab it properly. There seems to be weakness. Not his weakness, his strength. It's very strength. Because if it was possible, because every time you try and explain consciousness, think about it. Look, so simple. You'll only be able to give me an answer about what you are conscious about, your brain, not consciousness itself. Every time you try, you'll only tell me what you are conscious about rather than what is consciousness. It always will defy. Same with existence. You cannot try and encapsulate it. Existence, how do you encapsulate it? How do you capture it? So the deeper vision that comes out of spirituality cannot be in a way transferred into a very material frame, saying let us carry on doing research on the microtubules of your brain. It's not going to produce consciousness at all, I guarantee that. But if it does, then everything I've said is worthless. And the idea of spiritual is dead. In fact, look, this is the important thing. When you have human beings, like the British Humanist Association say that Mr. Lakhani, humans are so important, we focus on humanity. I say, wonderful, I do the same. But there's a big problem. You are telling me I'm nothing but accidents of evolution that has produced me. I'm nothing more than accidents of evolution. There's nothing more to me. I'm just a lump of carbon that got wound up like this. You are telling me this is dignifying me? Lump of carbon? This is not dignifying. So I said, move from this highly stodgy materialistic humanism to this idea of spiritual humanism. You are more than matter. You require the material frame to manifest yourself, your true nature, and yet you are not, if you like, part of, if you like, the output of matter.
So you wouldn't say that its explanation for spirituality is actually not consistent at all?
No, it is not consistent. It will not. It is impossible. The thing is, it's in a different field, it's a different realm. And it cannot, in a way, that's why the apparent realm cannot reflect it. Dr. Syed said something very nice. He said, you got a drop and you got the ocean, essentially the same. And yet, they are kind of linked up at the deeper level. In the same way, consciousness is, if you like, part of the greater consciousness. And consciousness is always singular, it's never plural. The apparent world we see with all different people being conscious, different living things being conscious, is like appearance. It is consciousness itself, one singular, appeared as scattered as all the living things.